Hello students, how are you? How is your last session? It is short and simple. I believe if you listen to it carefully, you will definitely understand the things over there. These video lectures are a good platform for you because when you're going to an exam, you can just recall everything in just one day by watching these videos again. Sorry to say this, guys. This may be my last class, and I think I complete almost everything in your syllabus. If I left anything, please do inform me. I will complete it. Guys, definitely I will come to your class before you complete your second year. Study well, train yourself, guys. Don't forget one thing. If you are talented and training yourself to become the best, everything will come to you. If you try to deceive yourself and try to impress someone but not training yourself, the same people will laugh at you to who you just tried to impress. So be careful. All the best, guys. Okay, let's start today's video lecture. In this lecture, I am going to complete the 5th unit. This may be a bit longer video, so do pay attention. Our first topic of today's is digital form. Students, just listen, a digital firm is just like any other company, but in which almost all significant business relationship, say like with the customers, suppliers and employees, the relationship with them are digitally enabled. That means the relationship and communication in the company or between the company and outside world is purely with the digital technology. Then the company is called as digital firm. This means in a company, we have core business functions. Yesterday I told you what are the core business functions, 4 M's. Do you remember? Men, material, money, machines. These core functions are completed and managed through the use of digital networks. For example, let us take online trading firm eBay. You all know eBay, an online trading firm. What eBay does is, it acts as a bridge between the consumer and the seller. Suppose I want khadi clothes. I go to eBay and search eBay about the khadi clothes. eBay will take my order and place it to another suppliers who produce these khadi clothes. So eBay is connecting the customers and the suppliers. The whole process is done digitally. So physical communication took place. So no physical communication is took place. So it is a perfect example of a digital firm. Now you all understood what is a digital firm. Let us see what are the benefits of a digital firm. Students, if you understand the example, now just think yourself what are the benefits of a digital firm by reading this slide. First one is time saving. In digital form, the communication is through digital means. So it definitely leads to time saving, right? Space saving. If all the communication between the customers, suppliers and employees is through digital platform, so there will be no need for any corporate office. So it results in reducing the space. Next, if a firm want to change to a digital firm, it invests in technology. Say for example, for this purpose, they took subscription of ERP and invested money, which adds value to the company by investing in the technology. We learned about the material MIS in the last class. There, the information system helps the process of supply chain in a smooth manner using technological means, which improves efficiency in the inventory. CRM, that is customer relationship management. This is marketing MIS, where the record of customers and relationship with them is done digitally, which helps in maintaining good customer relationship management. From all above benefits, it results overall productivity of the organization. Next is MIS model for a digital firm. Students, we know in a digital form, all the core business activities are done through digital process. So for a digital form, the MIS to be installed should combinedly work with all the information systems you learn in the previous classes. Due to so much digitalization, the people presence and physical work will be drastically reduced. So the hierarchy of the organization will become more flatter than horizontal. From the picture, you can see the model how MIS is combined with all other systems in a digital form. Basic data collection is done at the base level with the TPS, that is Transactional Process System. Next comes the MIS systems like ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning, SCM, Supply Chain Management, CRM, Customer Relationship Management, etc., which combine the whole system. Next, we come to data warehousing and data mining, which actually done by knowledge management system. At last comes the executive support system. The model is similar to the general organization system, but it's more digital and physical presence is absent. Next slide. Now we will see how will be the structure of digital form. Before seeing it, once we recall what is the structure of traditional organization. We all know for traditional organization structure, a rigid hierarchical structure is seen. Work for each person is clearly divided. Students, for traditional structure, let us take example of our college structure. You can make out from it. Each faculty has clear instructions and work allotted to them. They are inflexible in terms of new changes. New changes cannot be seen quickly because of traditional structure. And they are slow to potential new markets, that is changes in the markets. Now consider a digital firm. Take Byju's, you all know Byju's, an educational firm and study application, you know it. It is the perfect example of a digital form. There will be no physical classrooms or students, but can teach very well through online. In digital form structure, the hierarchy is flatter, means in a horizontal way, because less people are needed to control the form. Guys, compare Byju's form to our college. You can understand everything, but in our college, we use long hierarchy structure. In digital form, the power is distributed balancedly and there will be no dilemma of reporting the work. Power is more delegated to lower level, so can take quick decisions like changing syllabus as and when required, but with some protocols. Having less employees, they involve them in every aspects. Students, you all remember the concept of MBO, Management by Objectives. I told it in your class. Just recall it. It is seen in a digital form. There will be no specific work hours, but deadlines are given to complete the work. They have flexible hours through the use of IT technologies. The employees have freedom to access to the internal organizational IT infrastructure to perform their functions. Guys, to understand the structure, just think about the Byju's organization and compare it with our college. You will definitely understand it. In the exam, you can write Byju's firm as an example. Next, we are going to learn about e-business models. Students, you know what is the difference between e-business and e-commerce? Since in the very first class, I told you all the difference between the business, industry, factory, firm, commerce, trade, auxiliaries to trade, etc. Do you remember it? I also told you one formula. Once see this slide, do you remember this, guys? On the board, I explained whole the business system. Business is divided to industry, commerce. Commerce means trade. You all know what is a trade. Plus auxiliaries to trade that are transport, banking facilities. Other means when the trade becomes big, it needs auxiliaries to trade in order to exist. When a trade is done with a manufacturing of goods, they combinedly form a business. Do you get anything from this slide? Students, don't forget the basics, okay? Now, e-business and e-commerce. You know the difference between business and commerce, right? E-commerce firms means they trade the goods, but e-business means they produce the goods and they trade the goods. That is the only difference. And these two, e-business and e-commerce, are comes under digital firms. They are digital firms. Now the models of e-business are, first one is virtual storefront, a website that allows a person to research orders and pay for the product online. Examples of virtual storefronts are Amazon, Flipkart, etc. Next is information broker. These brokers act like information agents and trade information as product for a price. Example of it is chaptersglobe.com. And next is online marketplace. Like our general market, all salesmen come to a place to sell the goods. It is called a market. Likewise, let's take eBay. It is a site where all different salesmen comes together and sells their goods, where different customers goes to the site and buys the goods from different sellers. So it acts as digital marketplace. eBay is the best example of online marketplace. And next is online service provider. Providers like Google, Firefox, all other search engines come under this model. Next are categories of electronic commerce. There are different categories. First one is B2C. B2C means business to the customer. Means if the products are sold from a business unit to the customers, then it is called as B2C firm. Example of it is Walmart. Next comes B2B, means business to business firm. Here sale of goods is done only to the business units, which means from big business unit sells its products to small business units. Examples of it is Arabia.com, Grainier.com, etc. Next, consumer to the consumer, means C2C. Individuals using the web for private sales or exchange. The best example is eBay, I already told you. Next concept we are going to learn is mobile computing. Students, generally mobile computing means computation takes place with the use of computer devices which can be moved. Ante em ledra ippudu mobiles use chestunnaru kada vaatito business computations, computation ante calculations kanaka meer chesthe and aa device ni meer move cheyagalugutunte ante mobile ante moving from one place to another place cheyagaligithe vaatini mobile computing antam. And mobile computing devices em unnai meeku telusuni, which are tablet PC, tablet which can be moved, smartphones, laptops, etc. Next, coming to the limitations for the mobile computing. So let us think we are using a mobile, that is a smartphone. Let us assume we go to a far long place, say Arku Valley. No. Let us think about the lockdown. We went to some grandmother's house where it is a village, and our faculty, that is we, are giving so much of work, so much of online classes. So what are the limitations you are going to face? Now you can easily understand it, guys. What are the limitations? First one is signal, right? Signal led. And later data. నా డేటా అయిపోతుంది, నా డేటా అయిపోతుందని ఒక్కొక్కటి గొడవ. నెక్స్ట్ సెక్యూరిటీ. జూమ్ యాప్లో క్లాసెస్ చెప్దామంటే సెక్యూరిటీ ఇష్యూస్ అంట. నెక్స్ట్ ఇన్ ఎ విలేజ్ కరెంట్ సప్లై అండ్ కరెంట్ కట్ ఆఫ్స్ వీ కెన్ సీ మోర్. సో పవర్ కన్సెప్షన్ ఈజ్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. బట్ ఇన్ ఎ బిజినెస్ కంటెక్స్ట్ ద పవర్ కన్సెప్షన్ ఈజ్ ఎ లిమిటేషన్. ఓవర్ యూసేజ్ ఆఫ్ మొబైల్ ఫోన్స్ లీడ్ టు హెల్త్ హజార్డ్స్. యు ఆర్ వెల్ అవేర్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్. And last limitation is human interface with the device. Yesterday I told you guys about mobile ERP. I also presented a picture of iPhone, which the mobile ERP is provided with the NetSuite. Hope you just recall it, guys. So if you took and install it, first you should know how to use it. It is also a limitation. These are some of the common limitations I said. Guys, I said the example just for making you relaxed in the middle of the video. And next topic we are going to see is business process outsourcing.